Notice that there are three rotation angles on the 3JS object. You can rotate around the X, Y, or Z axis all together. If you're controlling a plane, the X rotation is known as the pitch angle, since it pitches the plane up and down. The Y angle is known as the yaw or head direction, since that's the direction the plane heads. Z is the roll, how much you're rotating around the axis of the plane itself. In some other fields, these angles are called the X roll, Y roll, and Z roll. These angles are called Euler angles when used together in this way. They're named after Leonard Euler, a Swiss mathematician and physicist who lived in the 18th century. He was one of the most prolific mathematicians of all time. If you have ever run across the number E, that's called Euler's number. Euler invented using the sigma sign for summation. Just listing out his accomplishments would take a whole unit at least, but you get the idea. There's a great quote from Euler that sums him up for me. When he lost the use of his right eye, he said, "Now I will have less distraction." In 3JS, the Euler angles are applied to the model in the orders Z, Y, and X. I should mention that this order can be different in different applications. For example, the order Z, X, Z is seen in robotics. What happens if you rotate around two or more of these axes? The short answer is that the frame of reference changes for each rotation. This is actually easier to see than to explain. Here I'm changing the X rotation, and you can see that the plane pitches up and down. Now applying the Y rotation, notice that we're not rotating around the world's Y axis, but rather around a plane that is defined by the X rotation. In other words, the Y rotation is applied with respect to the plane's frame of reference, not the world's. In fact, all the rotations are applied with respect to the plane. The initial X rotation just happened to be aligned with the world. The Z rotation is also clearly changing with respect to the plane's orientation, rolling it along its axis. Euler angles are handy for flight simulators, robotic applications, and even mobile applications, as they can be used to describe the orientation of the mobile device itself. However, Euler angles can also run into limitations, such as the problem of gimbal lock. For example, say that I set the angle of rotation for the y-axis to 90 degrees. You can now see that the X rotation and the Z rotation have exactly the same effect. We've lost a degree of freedom under these conditions, limiting how we can move away from this orientation. I encourage you to play with the Euler angles demo that follows and get a feel for the strengths and limitations of this method of setting rotations. Definitely try setting the Y angle to about 90 degrees to see gimbal lock in action.